Good morning, Reading, Pennsylvania. Today we're going to look at some of the murals that are in the city of Reading, and they cover the whole community. This is a mural that's been installed down at the Stone Cliff. It was put up during the summer by the Olivet's Boys and Girls Club and Berks County Parks and Recreation and the Gilmore and Hines Foundation. Here's another beautiful mural at 3rd and Court Street, Reading, Pennsylvania. As you see, it occupies the bus station, and it's a mural that was put up by Dan Gorman, affiliated with the Goggleworks Center for the Arts. It's a mural that's reflecting the transportation system that occurred here in Reading, Pennsylvania. There's the Reading Railroad. It's a beautiful design mural. Here's a big Beaver bus. It's located right across from the Community Foundation. It's amazing how the murals can really transform the community. Here we are on the south side of Reading on South 4th Street at 4th and Chestnut. And here's a beautiful mural for a little garden that's been here for years and is still maintaining its presence. The theme is Winnie the Pooh. As you see, there's little sitting chairs here. It's a nice, lovely area for a mural for parents. There's a laundromat right next door where parents come and sit out here while they're waiting for their laundry. Just goes to show how some of the murals are just really being utilized in our community. This is Reading, Pennsylvania. This is the mural tour. I love these benches that are here for people to sit and appreciate the mural. And the title of this mural is the Folks Smoke Free Community. The colors are just immaculate here. This girl is about 15, 20 feet tall. Here we are at 8th and Penn at the Reading Farmers Market. Here's a beautiful mural that was put together by Ed Terrell and sponsored by the Reading Downtown Market. As you see, it shows all the fruits and vegetables that could possibly be bought at the market. But this is a fall season. This market will be opening again in the springtime. This mural is very beautiful and very colorful. It really changes the facade here in the city. Penn Street Market. Is it that the market? There's another mural put together by the Olivet's Boys and Girls Club, and myself, Ed Terrell, we painted it. This was designed by Jessica. It depicts children playing in a natural environment. There's a little girl blowing bubbles. There's a big bee right here pollinating the flower. See, these murals really light up the city. They really change the facade of properties, and they contribute to the creativity aspect of our community. Here's a big butterfly. The artists, they really put their heart and souls in these murals. This mural was put together by Jessica Chadwick and a team of young people from the Olivet's Boys and Girls Club, the MAP program. Here we are at Rose and Walnut Street, adjoining the Olivet's Boys and Girls Club. This is a mural that has been put here for a long, long time. It happened during the time of 9/11, 9/11/01. And it picturates the unity of the community. Remember those who we have lost but not forgotten. That is the theme of this mural. And you see how colorful it is. It's one of the oldest murals, I believe, that's in the city of Reading right now. It's been here for a long time. It's on Rose Street. Reach for the stars. Rose and Walnut. Here's another mural that's on Rose Street. It's located at Rose and Elm. And this mural was put together by Ed Terrell and the community of children and family that lives on this street. And as you see, it depicts many different characters. And these characters is the neighborhood of this street. This wall was always being tagged by many, many different people. So the community got together and they put this mural together, depicting different children that live on this street. Hello. Yeah, not too many people know that this mural is here because it's on one of the side streets in Reading, and it covers the whole building. It's about 150 yards long, this particular mural. And it starts out at the corner of Elm Street, and it goes all the way down the block. This mural is about 2 years old, and it just stretches the whole length of this building. This property is the Alvin's Boys and Girls Club. Ed Terrell came here about 2 years ago, and he worked with the community and the children, and we put this mural together to save face of this building because it was getting tagged tremendously. It was an eyesore, and the neighbors met with me, Ed Terrell, to put this mural together. And since it's been here, no one has defaced it. As you see, it's still intact. Some of the imagery is just amazing. This mural is located at Rose and Buttonwood Street. As you see, it looks like a road or a street that you can just drive right up. It's located at Rose and Buttonwood Street. This mural was put together by the Reading Beautification Project, but it hasn't been completed because there was lack of funding, and the season ran out, and the artist moved on. It's a huge mural. Here's a mural right off the street, off of Buttonwood Street. It was put together by the Olivets Boys and Girls Club. It's a depiction of various different scenes here in Reading. There's Reading High School, there's the Van Shell, the Reading Library. This mural here is also about 100 yards long. It took a lot of effort to put this together. It was put together by Mike Miller and the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. There's some trains, there's a Penn Street Bridge there. You can span out here and see that. There's an image of the Reading Hospital and a covered bridge. These murals are very, very beautiful and time-taking and well appreciated in the community of Reading, Pennsylvania. Here's another mural we come upon. It's under the Schuylkill Avenue Bridge. It was painted by the Reading Beautification Project about 4 summers ago, and it's still intact. The kids that put it together worked on a summer project with Ed Terrell, and it depicts some skateboarders on skateboards in the background, the rising sun. Before this mural was put up, this particular area was getting very heavily graffiti, and you see there's no graffiti here on this particular mural. The graffiti has stopped. We've put images here that the children can relate to. Here's another mural on Schuylkill Avenue. It was put together by the Reading Beautification Project. It's put together on a store. This was to take away a lot of graffiti about 3 years ago. It was part of that project of Reading Beautification Summer Project. Ed Terrell was the director of this project. There's lots of fruits and vegetables on this store that changed the corner tremendously. This mural is also located on Schuylkill Avenue. It's right across the street from that store we just looked at with the fruits and vegetables. This mural was put together by the Goggle Works Center for the Arts also about 4 years ago. And you see it's very beautiful. A lot of children worked on this mural. This mural is about 30 feet tall. It goes up the side of a building. The Beacon House. Beautiful mural. It's right inside of a garden. We're coming across a mural on the side of the Buttonwood Street Bridge. This mural was also a part of the Reading Beautification Project, directed by Mr. Ed Terrell. And this mural is one of the biggest murals we put together that summer. And it's a mural that has taken away a lot of graffiti, and it shows the silhouettes of the actual children that painted this mural doing various sports activities, riding bicycles. This is their silhouettes. So the children, they take pride in these murals, and they don't come and graffiti it and spray paint it like it was before we implicated these murals. These murals help to bring pride to the city. We're still down by the Buttonwood Street Bridge. We're underneath the bridge. And I am so pleased that these murals are still here and no one has wrote graffiti on them. These murals are about 2 or 3 years old. We did this during the Reading Beautification Project, and it's a scene of children bicycling. This is one of my designs of Ed Terrell. Before, down here was just horrible with graffiti all over the place. And now since these murals are here, the graffiti has changed, and we pan across to the other side of the bridge. What we tried to do was implicate some sports activity for the children that they were accustomed and used to, and they painted them very, very talently and very different. Here's another mural on the opposite side of the bridge, and it just indicates some people running, and they're running, and they're running up and up the side of the bridge. This bridge was also graffitied to the maximum. And we came and we implicated this design on the bridge. So now that you look at it, there's no graffiti on this bridge at all. And it's beautiful because it shows activity. It gives history and recognition to the activities that we do as human beings on the earth. We're just going to walk down, and there's a few more murals down here under the Buttonwood Street Bridge. A lot of people probably aren't aware of this. Mostly the joggers and the sports people see these murals. This is one of my most famous, important murals in the whole city of Reading. This mural is a graffiti mural, meaning we have worked with the graffiti community to install this mural. This mural was put here by the Reading Beautification Project along with the direction of Mr. Ed Terrell, and we got together a collective graffiti group of artists, and we came down to the Buttonwood Street Bridge. Underneath the bridge, we got permission from the city, and we put this mural together. And the reason why I'm so proud of this mural is because it gave recognition to a lot of the artists that normally you don't recognize in the city as artists. And this is what they wrote on the side of the wall. Thanks to Ed Terrell and the RBI, the Reading Beautification Inc. They let them put this mural up. Oh, here's one that has gotten tagged. We have to come down and repair this one. This is deep under the bridge. This is one of the last sections of the bridge. It's on the actual running trail itself. So I remember when we put this up, we wanted to put joggers here. And as you see, the graffiti artists-to-be have come down here and tagged it to the maximum. So what we'll do, we'll come out here again, and we'll touch these up and take away all the graffiti writing. It'll be quite a challenge, but it'll be worth our while. This is on the side of the bridge also. This is the last of this series. It's some soccer players. And no one has graffiti yet. And it's been here for 3 years. Before there was graffiti all over these bridges. Here we are at Barbie's Playground, where there's a big mural over the shed here. And on it says, "Our city, our community, we love you." This mural has been here for a couple years, and it just shows a bunch of images of people, children, at the playground. And this Barbie's Playground has been under great transformation. There's murals that have been painted here just to transform it and take away the blight. At one time, it was a pretty blighted playground where there was graffiti all over the place. And the artists of the community have come together to just brighten it up. And art can do that in a community where there's so much blight. It can actually bring color and brightness and add to the culture of that particular community. This is on Barbie's Playground. There's a picture of a train representing the Reading Railroad coming through the city at one time. They've even painted these rocks that are sticking out of the ground very colorful. That also transformed it and changed it into a very beautiful playground area. Take away all the graffiti. That's the most important thing, is that the art is organized and it takes away the graffiti of the city. Look at this very picturesque scene right here of children playing with an airplane. Another a child is doing a somersault. There's a pagoda in the background. This is at the Barbie's Playground. This mural is very, very beautiful. It was put together by the John Gilmore Foundation. They came and they renovated this playground. This is some of the positive things that has been depicturated here in the city. we're still at Barbie's playground, and we're doing a little walkthrough of the playground. Along the wall, they have painted some images of the activity that kids can actually partake in at the playground. And it looks like images of basketball players, people playing basketball, because right behind us is the basketball court. Yeah, very, very nice. The mural here at this Barbie playground has really changed the playground tremendously. This mural is at Schuylkill Avenue and Jefferson Street. It's on the building called the Union Community Center. And this mural was put together by Ed Terrell and the Lars Park Elementary School. This is a daycare center on the corner of Schuylkill Avenue and Jefferson Street. This property also was getting very hit by graffiti artists. And since we put this mural up, they have not put any graffiti over these images. This mural is like a landmark to the city, and you see how prominent it sticks out on this building and give this building some class. Here we are still on Butler Street. This is one of the most famous murals in Reading also. This mural was put together by the Reading migrant farm workers, a youth up at Reading High School, and the artist was Mr. Mike Miller. This mural depicts the future of the world, the girls holding the world. It's at a community garden. It's very prominent in the community. And it goes to show you how the murals can be put together in a way that they're really pleasing and attractive to the properties and the buildings in the community. This mural was put together in 2006. Why We Came is the name of it. There's a nice little mural on the corner of Front Street. It's in a little quiet place. It's just a little tree with a bird sitting in it. Just a little quiet mural in a very quiet, serene place. These types of murals are so uplifting for the children in the neighborhood. This little ant. It's just pictures and images of nice things as you are walking in the community. Very beautiful. Here's a mural that's painted on the side of the Front Street Bridge. And it's also silhouettes of the children that helped paint this mural. This mural was put together by the Reading Beautification Project. There's children jumping rope. There's children throwing frisbees. And it just goes on and on and on. All the different, the skateboard guy doing skateboard. There's a girl playing with balls. There's scooters, children on scooters. And these are the children who have painted this mural. This mural is right off of Front Street. It's located on the side of a property called Feet on the Street. It's a ministry organization where they provide activities in the afternoon and after school program. They have painted a mural that has this big street going up into a big old cross. Amazing. The concepts and the perception of the artists when they put these things together just to change the blight in the city. This mural is located at a garden on Pear Street. It's in the shadows right now, but it has mosaic all over it. You can't really see it, but it's a glorious mural. It's about 30 feet tall also. Here's a mural that's at the daycare center over at the Opportunity House. It was painted some years ago. It just has images of children all over the place. It's a very beautiful mural. The murals of Reading really changes the community. Puts a better perspective on things. This mural was put together by Mike Miller and some of the boys and girls from the community here. It's amazing. They've incorporated mosaic artwork. Look at this child's face, his expression. Here's another mural in Reading that everyone in the community is familiar with. This mural is located right behind Reading Area Community College on River Road going towards Comcast. This mural was put together by the Boys and Girls Club of Reading. The artists are Ed Terrell and Michael Miller. This mural depicts looking forward and looking backwards, going into the past of the city where boats used to go up and down the river, tour boats. And we have the electric company, the Metropolitan Edison Company, that used to be right downstream. We zoom in on it. And the images that you see of these young people are people that actually live in the community back in those back in the time the mural was painted. The mural was painted by a collaboration of the Boys and Girls Olivets, some students from Wyomissing School. And there's two sides to this mural. This mural was painted on an old canal lock. And we're going to go around the back side of it and see some of the images right now also. Here we are on the back side of the mural of the canal bridge that's located in the back side of Rack on the Reading Area Community College. It's located on River Road going towards the Comcast Center. This is some of the images from back in the days when the river was very well used and appreciated by the community. This mural is called Looking Forward, Looking Backwards. Here's a picture of a boat on the river. That must have been some glorious times. You see, murals can also depictuate the history of the culture and give some type of credence to the fundamental fact that this is a very strong and vibrant community with history. Here we are on North 3rd Street. We're looking at one of the prominent murals in Reading. It's called The Songs of a Father's Heart. This mural is located at 3rd and Washington Street. It's one of the murals that were put together by Ed Terrell and a collaborative group from the Community School of Music of Arts. It was called Musical Caravan. This mural depicts a father and his children playing music together and resting and relaxing in a very good atmosphere. These murals in Reading are very important for the revitalization for the community. We're hoping in the future to network and market with the city to put a lot of these murals throughout the area, because murals in the state and Philadelphia did a wonderful job. In Philadelphia, there's over 2,000 murals, and these murals, they bring in the trade of tourists. They have mural tours where people get on the bus and they go around and they see these murals, and these murals enrich the community 100%. And there should be some type of investment coming from the city, coming from the state, coming from local government, where artists can express themselves in the community that reflects the community's activities, life. It's like a recorded history of the activities and events of the community. They're documents of a city being vibrant. Here we are at 6th and Franklin, looking at one of the murals that was put up by the Council of Chemical Abuse and Ed Terrell. This is one of the murals that had a story to it. It was about smoke-free Pennsylvania. This was the theme of the mural. And the kids from the Olivets Boys and Girls Club, I believe, and some other youth in the city, along with the Council of Chemical Abuse, put this mural together. Some youth from the Hispanic Center. The smoke-free Reading. The group was called Busted. Yeah, they were out of Reading High School that worked on this mural. There's so many murals in the city that I just kind of lose count of them. And the theme of this mural was smoke-free. And the images that you see in this particular mural are some of the people from the community. This mural was put together by Ed Terrell, George Miller, and various other, Miguel Guzman. What this indicates is all the various different chemicals that are in tobacco. This was a mural of awareness and education to let people know that it's not good to smoke and some of the attribute of the bad habits of smoking. Busted. Smoke-free. This mural is huge. It's about 30 feet tall. And it's very colorful, and I imagine a lot of people have seen it. Okay. My name is Ed Terrell, and what I've done this afternoon was I took a walk through the city just to highlight some of the murals and some of the projects that were presented here in the community. These murals are very vibrant and very important for the city of Reading. We're hoping in the future that we can instill more murals in the city just to bring about the art and culture of our community here. Thank you very much for participating. And if you have time, get out of your cars and take a walk through the city. The city offers a lot of richness and vitality to just your visual concepts. Thank you.